Very good morning. I am very happy to share the information pertaining to the last segment in this module, that is air conditioning. In the earlier videos, I could deliver the technical content pertaining to internal combustion engines followed by refrigeration. But in this video, I will be happy to share information pertaining to air conditioning. So you are all aware of course learning objectives. We are focusing on refrigeration and air conditioning. To begin with, you all know that refrigeration and air conditioning are the means for achieving artificial cooling. That is why artificial cooling, air conditioning, they are very much closely connected. Before we know what exactly is air conditioning, we shall have a simple analogy. Before knowing the principle of operation, application, relevance, and other information, we shall see what exactly is that. You all know that air conditioning is normally done by humans. We have to effectively condition the air. Likewise, we have to effectively condition air. So air and air very closely connected. How exactly we condition air, in the similar way we have to condition air. That is why air conditioning is very prevalent. When we just see to the historical perspective, we are already aware of the historical sense of refrigeration. When exactly was the first ever air conditioner developed? Who is responsible for coining the term air conditioning? We have to see. In 1902, an American engineer by name Dr. Willis Haviland Carrier is responsible for inventing the first ever air conditioner. But in 1905, Stuart Kramer is responsible for coining the term air conditioner. But what exactly the definition of air conditioner or air conditioning? We normally expect artificial cooling to happen. But to achieve this, what are all the thermodynamic processes or observations we need to keep in mind? The first and the foremost thing is control of temperature and humidity are important. Next, heat removal, then removal of moisture, then maintaining normal temperature, they are all very important. Therefore, air conditioning is defined as a process of simultaneous control of temperature, humidity, cleanliness, circulation of air, and checking the purity. That is very important. See, before the development of refrigeration and air conditioning, in the prehistoric era, people were aware of the means of artificial cooling, but not technically. In a very crude way, they used to follow that. But after 1750, after the development of refrigeration, then after 1900, air conditioning gained popularity. That is why refrigeration and air conditioning are the modes for achieving artificial cooling. When we see to the classification, we find summer air conditioning, winter air conditioning, we have split air conditioners, then we find centralized air conditioning system. There are many. When we see to the depth of air conditioning, it is definitely immeasurable. So, the principle of air conditioning is very analogous to the principle of refrigeration. When we see to this slide, we can get the clarity about a typical air conditioning system. Window type air conditioning system normally used for domestic and commercial application. Nowadays air conditioners is ubiquitous. You find everywhere. Without the use of air conditioners, it is not possible for us to survive. So, when we take the principle of operation of split air conditioner, we will come across some of the components like evaporator, compressor, condenser, evaporator. These names are not very new to us. Why? Because the names evaporator, compressor, condenser, expander, we had already come across in learning refrigeration system. The same old components are encumbered here. In addition to that, we find capillary, then we find ducts, air filter, they are all important. Why? Because along with the circulation of air, we even check the purity of air, that is important. So this is the image wherein we get the clarity regarding split air conditioner. Now when we come to the principle of operation of air conditioner, this schematic will clearly project the idea regarding that. Usually the condenser part is kept outside the building, but the evaporator is maintained within the wall of the room or a building. Why? Because we have to experience cool congenial air. Human comfort is very important. In order to experience cool congenial air, these components play a very dominating role. So evaporator, compressor, expander, condenser, the same old components are used. So within the building or within the room, we have to experience cool air, but the hot air or warm air is sent or dissipated to the surroundings. So that is why you can see to the arrangement. I just said the principle of operation of an air conditioner is very analogous to refrigeration. When we know the concept of refrigeration, understanding air conditioning is very simple. So this schematic will project clear information regarding the principle of operation. Next, when we come to the application of air conditioners, we have to discuss in detail, but since we discuss the information at the surface level in elements of mechanical engineering, we preferably take up comfort application and process application. When we take up comfort application, residential buildings, institutional buildings, commercial buildings, transportation come to picture. But when we take a process application, hospitals, industrial environment, nuclear power plant, chemical processing labs, biological labs, textile factories, printing mines, food processing come to picture. So the definition of air conditioning, the historical perspective, the brief explanation of air conditioning, principle of working of air conditioning, and application are very, very prevalent. So friends, till now in all lecture videos we have discussed the information regarding internal combustion engines, refrigeration and air conditioning. So this is what I was very much keen to convey the information. I profusely thank VTU eShikshana for giving us an opportunity in delivering the course content pertaining to refrigeration and air conditioning and also internal combustion engines, one of the modules in elements of mechanical engineering. And also I wholeheartedly thank Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, my institution, for giving a wonderful opportunity in sharing the content. Thank you. So I think all content have greatly benefited you. Wish you have a bright future. Thank you. Thank you very much.